morning, folks. I woke up grateful for life, but still with like a multiplicity of things like on my brain, like it was funny this morning. Today was Jared's dinner dance and party at his school, so he didn't have to wear suits and things like that. And before he was leaving, also as he was getting dressed, you know, I laid hands on him and I anointed him and prayed for him. And this morning, I mean, it's not like he fights me for prayer, but this morning he was just like, okay, take as long as you want, Mom. Say what you want, Mom. And I know it was predicated off of that neighboring school that had the 20 slashings, you know, the 16-year-old kid stabbed. They thought it was 20 people, but it was 22 people. 20 students, one teacher, and one security guard. But it's just something. I'm like, now of course the first initial thing was like to grip me with fear, like, oh wow, that's the school district that, you know, I was contemplating on moving into. That's a better school district. You know, where we're at is like a 7.75 and where they're at is like an 8.5, you know. I have a son, an African-American son. I'm a single parent, so, you know, it's all about education. And then, too, you know, I want the best for my kid. But, time's 8:09. It's just amazing, honey. Just how trials and tribulations can, like, change a person's mindset. Like, seriously. I went to school with. Okay. But anyway, I was just thinking that, oh no, I got too much going on. I was just thinking how, you can, I'm just trying to park you guys, I'm sorry. Wait a minute. I know, just too much going on. And today is a meeting for another program for Jared to be in. I'm sorry, folks. I can't even, like, focus. Yeah, another program for him to be in, as well as he has drum lessons tonight. And he has drum lessons. And then it's just, we just have so many things that are like always compact in like one day. And it's not that I mind them being compact, but a lot of the things, like, okay, I chose to move to the suburbs for the peace, the quietness, the everything that comes with living in the suburbs. However, the city offers more things than the suburbs. Like, the suburbs may have like 5 things versus the city has like 20. It's almost like Apple and iPhone and Droid. Apple and their applications, they have like maybe 30 apps. Android has 20,000 apps. Granted, it's not too far off, but when it comes to your children, of course, like, you want the best. But anyway, so yeah. So it's like a bunch of constant, like, ripping and running. Oh, sidetracked. Late last night when we got in from church and everything, then we went out to eat and was playing. And, well, you saw, like, the videos and stuff like that. But we just stayed up, cleaning a little bit, playing around. He had to get in the tub. Well, he needed to be drowned in the tub because he had baseball practice as well. But, Moo called. Well, no, she didn't call. She texted and was just like, good night, Mommy. I love you. So I replied back, good night, Janaea. I love you. You know, it's so funny how you can tell, like, she wants to, you know, at least call and ask and say something like, well, Mommy, why haven't we talked? And Mommy, but she knows why. She knows why. Things have changed ever since when I bumped into her at the mall and she just wasn't doing what she promised me she was not going to do anymore. I'll say that. But you know, she has to choose to change. Like, bottom line, no ifs, ands, or buts. She has to choose to change. So, hopefully. Yeah, okay, now back to church. Now, last night, honey, my son is so funny. Because, like, the pastor where we go, you can tell he has fire in him. And it just seemed like he's always holding back. And we're used to being a part of, like, fire baptized Pentecostal type churches, so we can tell, like, when the spirit's about to move, we can tell when the spirit's about to, you know, come down, and, you know, all of that. So, Jared made a joke last night. He said, he reminds me of, you know, like, people, not just in our church, but if you're, you know, if God's trying to equip you and bless you and fill you with the Holy Spirit, and how sometimes people talk in tongues, but they try to talk in tongues. Some of them do get the tongues at that time, and then some of them is just like until, like, it comes. Honey, Jared is crazy. He said that's how it seemed like the pastor is at the church. Like, you know, he wants it. You know, he wants, like, he wants the church to be, like, fire and anointed and people jumping and dancing and speaking in tongues. But, like, I don't know if he's scared or he's just like, like, he hasn't gotten it yet. My point is for Jared to be able to make that revelation and just, like, format it like that, because it is the truth. But for him to do that, and he won't be 12 till May, honey, it was just so... it was funny, interesting, and so true. You know, I talk to him about Timothy, now, in the book of Timothy all the time. Don't let people despise you because of your youth. God, honey, a lot of kings were 8, 9 years old. You know, biblically, and even, like, the Ming Dynasty, like, in China, things like that. Honey, sometimes look at England, when they're birthed, they're already a prince. So, you know. But anyway, I just thought that was so funny because, you know, when we leave church, you know, we always talk about what happened, you know, what did God do for you, blah, blah, blah. I know it may seem weird, but that's the type of relationship me and my son have, even though he's a kid. But it's a good thing, though. But we was talking last night, and I said, Jared, did you see how, like, Pastor Buck, like, had different people come up? And basically, he didn't call it that, but it's basically, it was like testimony service. He was like, I know, right? I said, I know, like, thank you, Jesus. And I was like, and then did you see how, you know, after they gave their testimony, he gave words, then we prayed. You see, even his prayers are different. I was like, glory be to God. You know, and he started laughing. And then he said, you know, he was like, and then we came up to the altar. And he was like, Mom, you was telling me to go up to the altar, but Pastor Buck had called for teenagers to come. And I said, Jared, it's a cultural thing. Like, multicultural churches and then Caucasian churches, when they say teenagers in that setting, we've been in enough. I know, but he just can't seem to get the concept. They call everybody a teenager, like, you know, unless, like, you know, you 2 years old, you know, if you're in school, elementary, middle school, that means come to the front. You know, they include you in that pal. And I said, because think about it. Because, you know, we're used to order, you know, if you say, I need 10 people to do this, you know, ages, this and this to do that. I need youth. I need kids, because there's a different, you know, kids, youth, teen, young adult, you know, it's different. But that's the structure that we've been, I'll say, accustomed to. But I said, Jared, from what happened at that school, he just wouldn't pray for people who are in high school. He will also pray for, you know, at this point, kids in school in general. And he's like, oh, I get it. But he said teenager, and I'm not a teenager. I know I look like a teenager, but I'm only 11. I said, baby, I get it. I said, it's just the formalities that their culture uses. That's all. But you saw after I was like, no, go anyway. Even if that's not what he meant, but I know that's what it was. I said, because once you got up there and you saw there was other kids even younger than you up there, I said, even if that's not what he meant, it's prayer. You're not going to pray for these set of kids and that man, and we belong to this church, so that's why I sent you. But I said, you know, you saw after that there was other people there. But anyway, yeah. So, all right, that's about it. Alrighty, God bless you. Bye-bye.